What's going on, everyone? Design Coolm here. Welcome back. And the gameplay you're watching is not Black Ops 3, which is pretty obvious. This is some Rainbow Six Siege. Me and my friends were playing Rainbow Six Siege on Friday night, and I figured, what the heck? I'm gonna record a little bit, and this is some Terrorist Hunt. It's one of our favorite modes. We really enjoy playing Terrorist Hunt. We played it a lot when we were playing on the other Rainbow Six games in the past on the 360, and we just really enjoy playing the Terrorist Hunt a lot. So you know, it's a good time. It's a lot of fun, and we really enjoy this. So what do we have for today's video? Well, you know, there's all this talk about the cross-platform capabilities and all this stuff, and of course everybody's getting their opinions in, and yes, you're gonna get my opinion here near the end. But I came across a really interesting little tidbit here, little article that may kind of give you guys a little bit of insight into how difficult this might possibly be. It sounds really simple and it sounds really cool. I mean, I'm all for playing, you know, with people on Xbox, but we'll get into that later on. I kind of want to go over this stuff here. So Eurogamer caught up with the Sony Worldwide Studio head Yoshida at GDC, this, you know, when the Game Developers Conference was going on, and they stopped him to ask him about the cross-platform, okay, just to kind of get his input, his idea as to whether or not this was something that's possible, or you know, when it might even be able to happen, or anything like that. So I will have a link in the description, you know, for this article that I came across, and it's really short. It's a short article, but you know, it kind of gives you a good insight into what, you know, what might be the roadblock, okay? Because there's definitely going to be some roadblocks in terms of this. You know, a lot of us think it's so we're just going to flip a switch and everything's going to be great, you know. This really kind of gives you a little bit bigger picture as to, you know, whether or not this is even something that might even be possible, you know, in terms of Xbox and PlayStation. So this is him, you know, quoting him. This is what he said when Eurogamer asked him the question, you know, whether or not this is possible. And this is what he says: because PC is an open platform, it's much more straightforward. Connecting two different closed networks is much more complicated, so we have to work with developers, publishers, to understand what it is they are trying to accomplish. We also have to look at the technical aspect, and the technical aspect could be the easiest. We also have to look at policy issues and business issues as well. So what he's saying here is, it turns out that, you know, getting beyond the policy and business side of things, you know, in terms of the Xbox and the PlayStation platforms, is probably going to be the most difficult part than actually getting the two networks to basically work together. You know, that the technical side sounds like it's going to be the easy part, but it looks like the business side of things is going to be the harder part, which is kind of what I was thinking when this was all coming out in the beginning, is that, you know, getting the two consoles to talk to each other and people being able to play together is probably the easiest part, but it's the whole business side of things, you know, because how is it going to work? Are, you know, as PS4 owners, is there going to be an additional fee that we're going to have to pay in order to be able to connect with the with Sony's network, you know, with Xbox Live, is really where my thinking is, you know. And there's going to have to be all kinds of licensing, you know, in terms, you know, between Sony and PlayStation and all this other stuff, and it, when it comes down to developers. Now, as far as I'm concerned, you know, here's my personal opinion on this, okay? I really don't have a problem playing with people on Xbox Live. I mean, I like Xbox Live. I don't have an Xbox One right now, mostly because I just can't buy one. You know, that's the reason I can't get it, is I just can't buy one. But would I buy one if I had the money for it? Sure, I'd go out and buy it, no problem. You know, but I just don't have it. So would I play with other people, you know, on Xbox Live? Yeah, I would do it. Now, in terms of PC, I really don't think I want to do that, you know. And like everybody else has been saying, it really comes down to the fact that it's a PC and it's the whole mouse and keyboard deal. You know, that's really where it comes down, you know, what it comes down to pretty much for everybody. I really just don't want anything to do with, you know, cross-platforming, you know, Call of Duty on the PC, you know, between the PS4 and the computer. So there you have it, folks. That's kind of where I'm at with it. So, you know, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to give it a like, favorite, subscribe. God bless, Godspeed, and have wonderful days and all that good stuff. And I will catch you guys in the next one.